recipe. And I can erase the... Hey, YouTubers, makeup junkies, and everybody out there. This is Michael Scott coming at you. I just got two free palettes from Lime Crime. I got the Alchemy and the Aquitania. Because I had a couple that got damaged. So, and they were going to be Christmas gifts, but they told me to go ahead and keep the ones that I had and that they'll send replacements. So I'm super, super duper excited about this. I did an unboxing video as I normally do, and I just made it unlisted and private, and I sent it over to them in a copy of the email so they could see. And they let me keep them because, you know, there was a pan damaged, and they're just really awesome in their customer service. So I got the Aquitania and the Alchemy palettes. And I've done my best to kind of press down the incantation in this one. But these are amazing, amazing palettes. I went ahead and laid down some eyeshadow helper from Lime Crime because that's my number one. And there's a few colors I'm wanting to work with here. It's just really hard without to decide any reservations, without any bias whatsoever. Lime Crime eyeshadows are the best that I've ever used. They are out of this world. They're absolutely out of this world. They're super pigmented, just like all of their lipsticks and everything. So I feel so lucky to have gotten these two palettes and all these other colors to work with. They're amazing. So I'm starting out with Spellbound. I'm just doing that in the inner corner of the eye. And it's kind of this, it's not like a pure white, but it's maybe like a champagne white is what I would call it. And then I'm really wanting to put a lot of fun colors in this, so I'm going to go into Aquitania, and I'm going to grab the Coral of the Story, which is their coral color in here. And these shadows blend together too, like butter. It's just really amazing. So they're uber pigmented. They blend together like butter. They're super, super fun colors. You know, Lime Crime is going to be so, so, so huge. And I feel so lucky to be one of the people that's, you know, started out with them before they got like monstrous, because when people start using this, there's just no going back, you know, to a lesser quality item. And when you've got shadows that blend like this and are pigmented like this, I mean, the BH Cosmetics, the Coastal Scent, even MAC, it's hard to compare to this stuff. It's just that amazing. So I need to get kind of a neutral matte down in my crease area, so I'm going to use Omega, which is a good nudish color. And I'm going to use a MAC 286 brush just to pick that up. I'm just going right on top, kind of in the windshield wiper motion. Alright, so then I'm going to start stippling that up. Actually, you know, I'm going to go into a bigger brush to help blend it out. So I just got this brush and I really, really love it. It's the 224. Which is just a big fat blender. And so I'm just gonna go right on top with it and blend like so. Now that's the other thing though, MAC brushes are, you can't really beat MAC brushes. And so when you've got killer eyeshadows and killer brushes, just really good eyeshadows and really good brushes, it's really gonna make a huge difference in the way you apply and wear your makeup. There's no doubts about that for me. All right, so I'm going to stay in the Aquitania just because the colors are so bright and beautiful. And I'm going to decide on what I want to throw in with this. I'm going to touch up that orange a little bit. Alright. I think I'm gonna use Atlanteo. I'm gonna use the 286 to pick it up. And the 286 does pick up a lot of product. I'm gonna go right into the eye socket right here. And then back and forth. Notice I still have not lifted my brush up from my skin. Now this is a shimmer, and I generally don't do shimmers. That's when I have the China doll and the other one, the D'Antoinette, which isn't really necessarily mattes or the normal mattes. They're really kind of lighter, paled colors, but the China doll is definitely great. With being your basic matte colors. So I'm just picking up a little more of the Atlanteo. I'm going to go ahead and go into my 224 real quick. Blend, blend, blend. Okay, go back into my 286. And do just this little bit right here. And you can see it blends right out to get that really good gradient effect. And you know, it's such good eyeshadow that you've the shimmeriness of it going up color. So in person, it's. Alright, so next I'm going to go into the one that had broke originally in this one, which is Nautical Prime. Ooh, I got a lot of that color. I'm down now, but I'll be standing tall again. I'm not sure why, but I'm just really wanting to do a kind of a fair shape on this eye. I'm just very gently pulling that Nautical Prime into the Atlanteo. I'm not chancy. Alright, so then I'm going to go into Mylar and do my art, my brow, my highlight. For this, I'm going to use the 214. Just use whatever brush you prefer. I'm just going to start on the arch and go back towards the end of the eyeshadow in the end. Still not lifting the brush. I'm going to blend a majority of this in on the first application. Once you've got a bulk of it blended in, then you can start blending kind of down and out. But this is a really great matte as well. Right, now I'll go back into my 2. Oops, let me go to my 217. End with my makeup wipe. Oh God, I love these colors, and their blendability is just really is mind blowing, guys. I never want to use another eyeshadow again that's not made by Lime Crab. So I'm just going to add that orange to the middle of the bottom. As you can see, I already brought the white down, so I'm just going to blend that in. Touch up the teal weeds a bit. Again, just very gently. 17. I just have a napkin that I keep down here, and I keep wiping off any excess shadows. And I'm going to take some orange and blend that a little further out. Missing some of the purple, so let's get some of it in there. Just right on the end. So I'm going to get some black eyeliner going in my lower, my lower lash line. So I'm going to do, because this is kind of an older, cheaper one, I'm just going to take a lighter and heat it up a little bit. I know a lot of you know about this trick or have used it 1,000 times. The key is just making sure you're letting it dry for a second, because you could clump. Be too hot, so I just kind of blow on it for a second. So I just kind of did the top water line on the outer and the inner. So really the only color that I didn't add in here is the green. But now I have to decide which eyeliner I'm going to use. I'm considering Sixth Element. Nope. Alright. Orchidaceous Citrus or Blue Milk. I'm thinking the Blue Milk. So I'm going to end it right there. As you can see, I got some of it on my lash, and that definitely can happen. So, I'm just going to get that dried real quick. But so far, here's my lime crème eye. I know it's not showing up coloration-wise to you guys as it is to me, but I'll get some pictures. I'll try and take some video with both of my other cameras, and we'll see if we can't show some true color. Okay, so all right. So then, why not throw some more lime crème in here? So that's Pink Velvet. Lush Emotional Brilliance. Brush with it. But if you let it set or bake, which technically I don't have any foundations or anything on, but I do have all my
Shiseido skin moisturizer, so hopefully it'll adhere to that. But yeah, if you let it bake in, it'll adhere to the foundation or primer or whatever you've got on. And then let's go ahead and grab some skin finishes and a blush. No, I want to use Vintage Grape from MAC on this one. There we go. And I also want to use, not Petticoat, but Light Flesh. So there's Light Flesh in the middle, I skin finish. And then Vintage Grape, which is just a regular purple blush. I'm going to grab the 1-8. Go right on top of it, just on the top line. And underneath that highlight. Kind of just like, oh, it is just like mascara, except for the brow. Nice thing, you can bring the brush down to your skin, and you know, gently brush across your hair, and it doesn't generally leave any stain on your skin. And it's just really great for getting your brows done in no time at all. You know, just fully in. Absolutely love this stuff. Using it, it is just great. This is a fun eye for Lime. I'm just loving Lime Crime. All right, kids, so there's my first full-on Lime Crime eye. With lips, a little bit of Vintage Grape, and then Light Flush, and Lush for the highlighter with some Chanel Le Volume Mascara, and Blue Milk eyeliner. God, I know it's going to be demonic sounding, so I'll do pictures, and I'll try and fix this somehow. We'll see. Hey, everybody, so we're back, and it's actually been probably about 2 hours that I've been wearing this eyeshadow because I went ahead and edited the video and took pictures and did all of that stuff. I even wrapped a present while I was waiting for pictures to transfer off of my phone onto the computer. So I was thinking, you know, obviously, number one, I've got no creasing. Everything has stayed exactly where it is. The eyeshadow helper is just, it's waterproof. It stays for 24 hours, so it's really, really great. And I really love this eye. Even Elliot liked this eye. So I thought one more thing we could do at the very end, if you really wanted to amp it up and just Lime Crime it out, is to grab some glitter. I'm using a really old glitter base. It's not to say that it's not any good, but it's Too Faced Second Base. Now, they don't call it Second Base anymore. Back when their primer was called First Base, they had a glitter base called Second Base. So I've just had it for a long time. I don't use a lot of glitters, but Lime Crime's glitters are so high quality and so beautiful that I've been using theirs a lot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this, and I figured we would do the brow. So this glitter base dries clear. It doesn't really, you know, you can put it on top of eyeshadows easily, and it won't cover up the colors of the eyeshadows or anything like that. And the glitter will stick generally right to this and hopefully not anywhere else. When you're doing an area like your brow, though, you're going to have to be extra careful if you're not wanting it in your eye. So, or, I mean, you obviously you want to use an eye-safe glitter, but I don't really want to get any of the glitter into my shadows. So, what I may do is probably hold a card up. I've decided I want to use the Ophiuchus, which is like their disco ball in the jar, is exactly how they describe it, and it's exactly what it looks like, and I absolutely love it. They're just, it's such a fine quality glitter, too. It's, you notice a difference right away than any other glitter that you've ever used. You know that this is really good, really high quality glitter. So I'm just going to use my pinky and kind of keep my head out a little bit. So it only goes into the areas that I want. And like I said in several videos, I'll say it again, I like to keep the stickers in these little containers that have the holes through them. I just find for my own personal liking that it keeps them a little better contained for the way that I like to keep my things. So I'm just taking a brush and wiping off the excess. I've actually got a makeup wipe right here, so I'll probably use that. And then boom, right at the end, you've really amped up this eye. You know, this would be really, really fun for clubbing, anything like that. You can even kind of dot along here in your eye if you've gotten any. Since this primer is waterproof, you know, you don't want to rub since this is a makeup remover wipe, but you can certainly blot up any excess. So that's kind of just my little last fun twist in my ode to Lime Crime and everything that is beautiful and wondrous and fun coming out of Lime Crime. So, all right, guys, this is Michael Scott saying have fun, and have fun with makeup. Goodbye, guys.